Beautiful people out there. This is Pastor Deena. Again, I am sharing today that if there is a prayer need, you can send in your prayer request. We will be taking them to the altar before the Lord. If there is anything that you would like us to pray for specifically, let us know. We believe that God is a God of promise and that He's a God that keeps His promise. We know that sometimes we have to go into warfare and we need to pray. Everybody doesn't understand it and everybody doesn't believe in it, but we know that our God is a God that answers prayer. And if we would lay before Him at His feet those issues, because He says He's concerned about you, He's concerned about me. In your warfare against the sickness, against the financial struggle, against all the circumstances that we're dealing with, we want to stay in the Word of God. We want to stay in worship. We want to always pray, and we need to declare some things. So we want to declare that our prayers are being answered and that He is our peace. We are declaring that we walk in the power and in the strength of so when God is going to do something, we want to put the seeds out there. We want to give Him everything that He needs from us in order to move. And number one would be our faith. The Bible tells us in Isaiah 41 and 10, "Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your Lord." He says, "I will help you." He said, "I will uphold you with the right hand of my righteousness." So we want to put on the full armor of God so that we may withstand the enemy. We want to cause him to flee from us. We want to bind up those things that are ungodly. And we want to loose the love and the power and the Holy Spirit of God across the earth. We want to exalt him. We want to lift him up. He is Almighty God. He is wonderful. He is deserving of all our worship and all of our praise. Stay prayerful. Keep the faith. Hold your head up. Make sure that you have forgiven, that you have repented. Make sure that you have cleaned the slate and that you are giving God every opportunity to move into your life like He so desires to. Because He says, "I have plans for you. I think good thoughts of you. I think of ways that I want to bless you so that you can have an expected end." And that God does love us. He is not a God of torture. We want to be reconciled back unto the Lord. We have cut off our relationships with Him. We have turned our back and ignored His voice when He is speaking to us to tell us what He wants us to do. So in your mind, continue to think, this is what we have to do. We need to move by the Spirit. We need to hear Him speaking to us. We need to get into a place where our relationship is being built and that we are being strengthened in Him so that when things come, we can stand. We won't fall apart. We won't have a whole bunch of mental breakdowns. We want you to get to the place where you are no longer considering yourself a victim, but somebody that's walking in victory regardless of what has happened and what has gone on, that you are strengthened, you are taking back your power. I got a song for you for that one. But you're taking back the power that God gave you. And you're walking forward and moving forward. Those that have confessed Christ, those that are seeking after Him, those that are reading the Word of God, those that are praying to Almighty God and not being stirred and blown with every wind, wind of doctrine that causes us to be tossed to and fro and put us in confusion. God is not of confusion. God loves us. God is not in the midst of hatred. God loves us. God is not punishing every single person on the planet, as some people say in there. I don't believe in God. You know, why would He let all these things happen? We need to get in the will of the Lord. He is protecting His own. If you belong to Him, He is protecting you. This is why He has not come yet. He is giving everyone the opportunity to get into a better relationship with Him. He said, "I came that the world might be saved." He didn't come to put us down. We do that to each other. But God came. He sent his only son to come to set us free, to give us deliverance from things that have been weighing us down. You know, those burdens that keep coming and it just seems like you're just sinking and you're sinking. I remember there was a time where I felt like I was in a desert place when I could not hear from God. I pray. I'm fasting, I'm reading, and I could not hear his voice. And I thought, why am I here? And then those were dark waters where you can't even see land. You can't see the rescue ship coming to rescue you. All you see is darkness and you're floating and you're trying to stay above water. But God is right there. He says, stand still and see the salvation of the Lord. You stand still and let him do the work. He said, where the enemy will come at you one way, he will cause him to flee seven ways. This is a fight. This is a battle. All of our accomplishments, all of our deeds, all the things that we do, we still have to stand before a God that is going to, he will be the great judge. Stay in faith. Be strong. Ha, for the Lord is your strength. He said that we can do all things through Christ that strengthens us. He is our strength. There is nothing too hard for our God. He loves us. He loves us. He does love us. Be encouraged, my brothers and my sisters. I love you, family, and there's absolutely nothing you can do about it.